2 years ago today, the body of Celina Cass was pulled from this spot on the Connecticut River, ending a six-day search for the 11-year-old who vanished from her house less than a mile from here. To date, no suspect has ever been named. Celina's mother is still begging for justice.
Did the roses and the bouquets and these light up?
Louisa, proud of the large memorial she built this year to mark the second heartbreaking anniversary of her daughter's murder. Every day is a struggle. This mother is desperate for closure, which she says will only come with an arrest.
I think of her all the time, and sometimes she'll come to me at night.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I miss her so.
We've re-examined again.
Associate Attorney General Jane Young, along with Detective Belanger, visited last week, bringing fresh flowers for the memorial, but no new information about the case. Louisa says Jane Young told her they want to be sure when a suspect is arrested that the charges stick.
Jane Young and everyone knows what I want, and they want it too, as bad as I do.
Did they say that to you?
Yes.
Do you remember what they said to you?
They want justice just as bad as I do, and they're not going to stop.
Louisa's life has changed since Celina disappeared. She split from her husband of only 9 months, Wendell Noyes. Their divorce was just finalized on July 10th. Louisa and Wendell were two of four people besides Celina who were in the home the night Celina vanished. He purchased a mobile home about a year ago. The lot overlooks the area of the Connecticut River where divers recovered Celina's body August 1st, 2011. His truck was in the driveway when we stopped by.
Wendell?
Neighbors say Wendell keeps to himself, only socializing with his next-door neighbor. Louisa says the two have not spoken in years. Celina would be 13 now and entering the eighth grade. Louisa visits her daughter's grave once or twice a week and prays to her daughter every night. Gardening and crafts keep her mind occupied during the day, but the tears still flow every day as well.
It's never going to go away. I want justice. And we're going to fight for it. If we don't get it here on earth, we will get it in the afterlife.
Investigators insist this is not a cold case. They say information and tips continue to stream in. Everyone in this small, tightly knit community is united in the idea that they hope one day Celina's killer is caught. In West Stewartstown, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.